Alhaj Juma Al-Jab. I'm the district chairman of Ghana Muslim Student Council, democratically elected. This is my second term in office. I've served for 5 years. I've just begun the second term. In as far as the issue of petition is concerned, first of all, we need to know what is petition all about. Petition is somebody is right of each and every one. For a councillor, for a district cadre or district chairman to be petitioned, there are rules, there are procedures to be taken. First of all, this guy can be impeached, that's the right. It can be impeached by the councillors themselves, basing on the facts and reasons which they came across. I therefore want to put it categorically clear, this petition the people wrote are fake, null and void. The reason, this petition was wrongly wrote. First of all, if you want to write a petition, you should look at the councillors themselves. You sit down in the meeting, talk to the chairman calls a meeting whereby the allegation labeled against this candidate can be tabled before councillors, and the debate should be taken about. People should sit down and talk about that petition. They're not the final because this guy is appointee of the Mufti. His eminence the Mufti is who appointed him, and he's the one in charge of removing him. Once the council has sat for that meeting, that allegation accusation text will be taken on to the Mufti. From there, he will decide what to do over this petition against the district, much as it had happened. I therefore rule it out that petition have received it and it is null and void. Therefore, my people from outside should learn to do things. Whenever somebody has problems, you come through a channel to go through. You know, you don't wake up in the morning and say, so and so, I don't want him. That is absolutely out of order. We in Uganda Supreme Court, for us, we work with the Constitution. There is Constitution that guides us. I therefore want to put it clear, it is the issue of district secretary. This district secretary was dismissed, was actually dismissed by the district council, district executive council, dead member. Because the policymakers, whenever they want to do something, they seek advice, they seek guidance from the Constitution first. And as far as Article 10, subsection A, C, and F, states clear, whenever a secretary was found to be bankrupt, or was found of ill-fated as far as mine is concerned, and not of you, he is supposed to be suspended for a period of time. We therefore act within the law. We don't do things out of law. We suspended him in as far as our Uganda Muslim Council constitution is concerned. That is, I think, I've cleared the issue of petition. The issue of bicycles. Indeed, we received some donation from the President of Uganda. It was around 30 bicycles. These bicycles were truly divided in front of people. In front of the people here, we divided it, and we remained with 10 bicycles.
Nine bicycles.
One bicycle was given to our Imam of the Chief Mosque. 9 bicycles, a top executive sat, of which I was inclusive. We sat and we decided this bicycle be sold. It fetched around 910,000 Ugandan shillings. And this money we top on, and at the moment as I'm talking, we managed to buy this computer you are seeing. This computer was bought as a result of the nine bicycles sold by us. You can bear witness, for those of you who are here, these are the donations of his excellent president. As far as this computer is concerned, it's one of the donations donated by his excellent the president. There are a lot of accusations leveled against this Kadi that he saw his reach of their land. I don't know, in this council, when did the Uganda Council have land here in Arua? The only land they are talking about is the Agakan land. That Agakan land, ever since I was born, we knew that land belongs to the Asian. The Ismailia Foundation, chaired by His Highness, the other hand, I therefore want to put it categorically clear. That land doesn't belong to Uganda Supreme Council. That land doesn't belong to any Muslim in this district. If you want to grab somebody's land, please, you should have your documents clearly. This one has their land, they have their documents, time will come to prove. And as far as we are concerned, you've already received their documents. For us, we are calm, we don't want to go and circulate rumors. The facts, I know the facts are bitter, time will come, we shall know who the land belongs to, inshallah, with God's grace. The issue of motorcycle, yes, we received a number of motorcycles. The motorcycle we have distributed equally. Maracha have their share, because Maracha is land Arua Muslim district. Maracha, they have got their government district status. Time will come, they'll also get their Muslim district status. Maracha is under Arua, and they have got their share. We, as a district official, we divided this motorcycle equally. Arua got some four of them. Terego Muslim County got one. Ivy Muslim County got one. And Upper Marine Modern County also got one new brand motorcycle, Yamaha type. We also in the headquarters also received one. We kept it here in the office. We are using it. That is as far as motorcycle is concerned. For us, we do things in open. We don't hide things. This is our motto. Motorcycles are there. Whoever wants to use, bring his plan. We see and we release him the motorcycle and we use it. This is your vehicle. I don't know how any people are in this vehicle. This vehicle belongs to the Uganda Supreme Council and it is managed by the office of the district guard to help us in as far as our issue of Uganda Supreme Council officers are concerned. Therefore, this vehicle doesn't belong to individuals who want to be in town. This vehicle is specifically for our office. If you want to use it, come here, you request and you beg. Otherwise, people will get warned over this vehicle. Because I've been hearing rumors. Certain people, most of the time, will come, their limbs will be chopped off. They should be careful. This vehicle is specifically for the office of the district guard. Rice. I don't know. Some of them are up and running mad. I don't know. As if you don't eat rice at your home. Rice. A kilo of rice goes at around how much?
3,000.
3,000 Ugandan shilling. 3,000 can defeat two people. How poor, how hopeless are you? This issue of rice, I'm tired of it. For the last 3 years, people are talking about this rice. And I want people to get this one clearly. The issue of rice, I'm tired of it and I want to put it clear. On 17th of July 2015, we received a donation of food items from the State House brought by Madame Hajatanuna. This rice came in Arua, we received it. I want to put it clear, Arua is the mother district of West Nile. Yumbe, Koboko, Ajumani, Moyo, Nebi, all of them are under Arua, and as far as the government of the council status are concerned. Being a regional office, we received this item, we distributed a letter to all these district counties. Yumbe, Moyo, Ajumani came, they all received their shares. We divided, we divided this rice equally. Sorry, Mr. My brother, I've just come late. Let me continue on because you continue. The issue of rice, we have divided that rice equally. Every district received their shares. Me as a district chairman, I went with half a sack, around 10 to 15 kilograms to my home. That shows fair distribution. Yeah, we have given that the food items out as it was stipulated. In that letter given by Madame Hajatanuna. I've repeated that issue, the issue of motorcycle. We have divided equally. Nobody should doubt us. The vehicle is here. This vehicle, as you have seen it, is still new brand, simply because of maintenance. We have maintained this vehicle very well. Whenever time comes for service, we take it to service, and it used to help us a lot. Operation went to Kampala using this vehicle. The transport was a problem to us. Assuming this vehicle was not there, what would have happened? Therefore, this vehicle belongs to the district office. We are using it specifically for our administrative issues. Land, as I've said, land doesn't belong to us. This land of Mukhtar belongs to Asians. Time will come, the Asians will claim their land back because they have their repossession letter. In 1993, President Museveni went to London in UN Convention. The Asians were there asking for their property left in Uganda. A decree was signed by His Excellency President. But anybody who knows that he has his own property in Arua, in Uganda, should come and claim. And the majority of them came and claimed it. Therefore, I want to put it clear to those who are opposing to our representation here. You people stand on that land that belongs to us. That land of Aga Khan belongs to Ismailia Jamaat, the Aga Khan Foundation. His Highness, the Aga Khan was here some 2 years ago. His group were here, was here in the office, claiming their land, and they have their repossession letter. Arua Hill also given them excellent title. The each and everything was clear. I want to put it now clear, that land, the time will come, they will come and collect their land back. Less, for us, as a judicial leader, we are trying to talk to them, let's let them at least help us, at least let's share, at least half of it they should give to us, half of it they should take it back. Otherwise, if you want to use force, time will come, we shall lose that land, and we cannot get anything out of that land. Despite the fact we have kept it for the last 42 years. Therefore, Muslims, be aware that for us, we are Scotland. We are just simply there for the sake of Muslims. Let's know that very well. The issue of abattoir. Much as people are talking here, left and right, abattoir. You people should learn to behave. Whenever something happened in a rural Muslim district, come and confirm from the office. I'm the district chairman, democratically elected. You are the one who elected me. For me, I supervise this fund. For the last 5 years, I've supervised this fund. I did not get any problem with that fund. I've come to realize that there are other people, our competitors, who are trying to assume that they are fit of managing this office. Come to this office and ask, where is the man of Abattoir? What does it do in this office? Sit down, they will explain to you. The Secretary of Finance is there. Me, the chairman, is here. I'll be supervising them. I will talk to them. I will ask them to give to you that accountability. For us, we are accountable leaders. I want to put it clear, we are accountable leaders. Those of you who are thinking that we are eating money here, please come and challenge us here. For us, we like challenges. Such type of challenges which are developing to wherever we go. The issue of this is very peanut, the money we are getting from Abattoir is very small, which cannot sustain us. The management of this office is too wide, of which we don't receive any grant from above, neither from grassroots. Therefore, my brothers, my sisters, I was told that now the women are also talking. You talk as who? Women, for us, you women, you are under men. Listen from us, you are husband. Are we together? In another forum, I got also the other women who are trying to talk about this man. Stand on. Now, Muslims of Arua, be informed. For us, we are here democratically elected, and we shall be democratically removed out of office. It is the district qadi who is appointee of the mufti, and it is also the mufti who can also take him out of this office. We have our canon law, the constitution. A mufti, a district qadi, to clock 70 years. At the moment, he is still 59 years. For those ones who want this seat, wait for another more 10 to 11 years. That's when you come here and claim this. I want to be clear. The other sheikhs, the other young sheikhs, I don't know they came from where, I don't know. They claim to be sheikhs. I've come there are some with whom we have been studying in Bugembe. They left us there. By the time I reached here, I found that they are big sheikhs claiming to be the disregarded people. Stand on that. Next time, this is long lips of yours will be cut chopped off. Therefore, disregard, nobody should disturb this card. The country is stable. His Excellency President Seven said the country is stable. And it will remain. This stability is not joke with it. We want to joke with this stability, we will fail. And let me assure you, we will fail and we will fail badly. Put it clear, get it from me as a district chairman, democratically elected, nobody will joke with this peace we're enjoying. I was told this morning some of you wanted to come and close the office of the district guard, please. Stand on, the security is there, this country is stable, people fought for this stability. Right now, we don't want people to take us back. Initially, we used to take 1 million a day. Nowadays, I eat 4 times a day. Not even 3 times. 4 times for me. I'm as heavy, as healthy, as big as I am because I eat well. I eat well because I do a lot of work out of my own strength, not from the council here. I'm here as a part time. I used to do my work there. I came here just to supervise what is happening in the office. Therefore, my people, especially there are some notorious Muslim groups from municipality. The most notorious out of 15 counties, municipal Muslim county is the most notorious, and we shall deal with them. So long as we are here as their leaders, they told us their revolution will not come to an end. We are also telling them also our persistent guiding of this office will also continue. If you come by air, we are there fully. If you come by ground, you're also there. If you come, whatever means of challenging us, we are there. Even the cost of law, for us, some of us also read laws. Much as I'm not well versed in law, I have a number of lawyers that I will line up for you. Be warned, especially the municipal, the county sheikhs, the county chairman, the councillors, the sheikhs. Be warned, I want to put it clear without fear of ever. I'm the district chairman, I have to lead you properly. Therefore, with these few words, I've talked a lot.